Mr. Dittweiler, an old-timer there, owned the land where the dam is at, and he built a road into the area where the rapids, and you could go in and snag fish. And here he is collecting the quarters from us and the different people that go in and snag your bluebacks. This is a good picture of the old fellow. Nice old man. Here's in at the kind of a campground area he'd cleared. Sold coffee to someone of his boys, did I believe. Here's the number of cars that was in to see the catch to snag the bluebacks. Just a view of the campground. This is up on the bluffs, so high above the where you did the snagging. Quite a weekend's quite a crowd of people. Here's an old lady climbing the trail that Mr. Dittweiler dug out of the hill to get down to the rapids here, where the fishing was done. You had quite a ways down to the rapids. Here you're looking down on them, part of them. This area is all entirely covered by the Cabinet Gorge Dam, though it's a lake in here now. This is looking across the Clark's Fork to the other side, where a few people were coming from the other side to fish. He used a big triple bear hook and to try to find a place where the fish were and jerk, and you'd snag them, and so you couldn't see into the water. This shows you quite a few of the local people in there on weekends and no other days too, when the fish are running. Well, very good fishing. Many happy hours. Just the local people and people heard of this. Fish would run up and go up to different tributaries, the Bull River and other tributaries, and spawn in the fall of the year. Generally in September this would take place. October. Catch some fish same time. This is the game warden. It came in just to check. The snag was perfectly legal at that time. Here's old Mr. Clifford Weir, a good friend of mine, father. We stayed, had a little place of business up near the town of Knoxon. Here he is out on a rock, got out on this little island. He knew how to get him pretty good. You could catch lots of fish here. One time we caught a, went up there and caught all, practically a full wash tub full of them. Clean them and smoke them. They're very good eating. Called the blueback, or some people call them silvers. They come out of Pend'Oreille Lake. They're still in Pend'Oreille Lake. This is Mr. Weir. Portrait of him working, and He didn't know I was taking his picture, I don't think, here. Here and our little dog Tootsie. Different areas of the rapids there. This little old fellow in the background, that long pole, you'll see him a little later here. I think he... You could find the north slopes of tamarack, young tamarack, and they grow real long, and you'd peel them, and they'd make an exceptionally long, a good pole to snag them, and you could reach out a long ways to some place where you wanted to. He was one of the local character, the people who was up, lived in this area. This woman is putting fish into a box she's got there that she's caught. In the river, different places, and try to get behind a rock and rest going through the rapids, and if you could find that spot, you could jerk through there with the lead. Use this triple hook and with weight on the bottom of it, leaded weight, and cast on there, and go right down, and you'd yank, and if you was lucky, you couldn't see into the water, but you'd... try to find a good spot, and there was always young fish in there resting or going up the stream. This is just the rapids here. We're nearing the end of the film here.
Wally Gamble has generously donated the proceeds from this video to Cabinet Wilderness Historical Society Special Projects Fund. If you want to help preserve our history, contact Cabinet Wilderness Historical Society, Box 618, Knoxon, Montana. Thank you for your enjoyment. Wally Gamble has generously donated the proceeds from this video to Cabinet Wilderness Historical Society Special Projects Fund. If you also want to help preserve our history, contact Cabinet Wilderness Historical Society, Box 618, Knoxon, Montana, 59853. Thank you.